Hello, Magic. I'm really sorry, but I'm doing through my laptop this presentation because I know what's happening with the virtual platform. Okay, I have to do the presentation. The title of my oral presentation was how the development of 10 communicative strategies help intermediate learners, UCV students, to improve their communicative oral performance. As an introduction, I would like to say that Maleki, 2007, he talked about the art of communication. He said that communication is an art and we need to use some devices, linguistic and non-linguistic devices, to transmit meaning and to use it for communication. Also, Caron in 1990, he talked about the oral strategies, which is a mutual attempt of both interlocutors to agree on meaning. And different authors like Dorn Ray and Rebecca Oxford, 2005, they claim that training language learners to use can help students to keep going on conversation. That's why I decided on the issue of communicative language strategies. One of my personal justifications is, as you know, I've been a teacher in different for different years, so I have observed that the students struggle at communicating and they have a lot of problems when they communicate. They cannot keep conversations. So I wanted to help students in the frustration of communication. That was my first personal objective. And also I wanted to help teachers from the UCB department to have some tools to help students to communicate. We have to remember also that Oxford and Dorn Jay, they talk about that these teaching students communicative strategies help them to better their learning. They become better learners, they are more autonomous, and also they really perform better. And we have to remember also what is a communicative strategy. Rebecca Oxford talked about that it's kind of these strategies are kind of mechanisms that learners choose for at the moment of communication. And Brown, he is very famous because he talks a lot and highlights a lot about real communication. He says that communication doesn't take place if communicative strategies are not emphasized along with task-based learning and also feedback. Concerning the theoretical background, we have to remember that this issue was first studied by Tarons in the year 1995. He developed five different classifications of communicative strategies, like avoidance strategies, paraphrase, conscious transfer, appeal for assistance, and mine. And investigators like Caspert in the year 1983, Williams in the year 1987, they broadened the concept of communication and also the use of communicative strategies. But for the present study, I have decided to focus mainly on five different strategies. For example, they are compensatory achievement strategies, social strategies, social affective reduction, time gain strategies. And well, after this, I want to emphasize also, I want to mention that related to methodology, I follow the quantitative and qualitative methods. This is greatly emphasized by Creswes in the year 2005. He talks in his book that we need to make a balance in methodology, choosing the right method. So we use also the instruments like SEAL questionnaire for to at the beginning students were asked to complete this this original questionnaire of SEAL done by Rebecca Oxford, which is related to the different kinds of communicative strategies. Students took this questionnaire before and after the treatment. Also, students perform oral tasks, two oral tasks, one about personality and the other was to describe a picture, to describe a picture story. What else? Concerning to methodology, the treatment, I divide the treatment in two phases. Phase number one, I started teaching them the five first strategies, and the second phase, the other five. In the first, the first phase lasted about two weeks and a half, and I taught them achievement strategies and social strategies. And later on, the other 2 weeks, I introduce the social affective strategies, time gaining strategies, and topic and reduction strategies. Well, the lesson lasted almost for 45 minutes. 5 minutes I did the motivation, 20 minutes for a presentation, and 20 minutes for practice. And after the treatments, during the classes, a mentor was invited to observe the classes, and also students complete and reflect in their journals. I have also journals for reflection, so I collected the data through journals, through mentors' observation. And this, and also concerning also to data analysis, that was the most complicated because I tried to analyze data following the thematic analysis suggested by Hatch in the year 2005. This was very difficult because I have to read the different themes, make different relations. I have to quote the data, look for thematic patterns. So that was very complicated and took me a lot of time. And now I want to talk about the results. Some results related to the first question is that learners got higher scores during their oral intermediate test after post-test treatment. As I mentioned before, students took the oral exams not with me because I was the investigator. There was a teacher, an outsider, who evaluated the students before. The experimental group was evaluated before. This group of students, they belong to the University Students Intermediate 1. They range from 18 years to 27 years old, and they were chosen at random. So they were evaluated, and one of the results after the treatment of the implicit teaching was that their oral intermediate test scores got higher, which demonstrates that students really internalized the communicative strategies, that they really there was value for them and they learned the different strategies. Okay, and also it was observed from class videos that the following strategies were greatly used during the two oral tasks. One of these was circumlocution, also L1, L2 transfer, making time or hesitation, verbal strategies, paraphrasing, and nonverbal strategies. And also, it was observed from class videos and reported after applying the student statistic test. The transcripts of each communicative strategy was introduced into a program in the computer, and then all the data was processed using the T student statistic test. This test is used for investigation. It was a little difficult for me too in this part because I have to read about and I have to pay to a tutor to help me. But to work with this kind of data, but results were numbers were seen. Okay, results concerned to the second question. We have to remember that the second question is related to if learners perform, if females perform better than males. Well, I have one of the results was that there was very little difference, statistically talking, about the scores and the results between females and males. It seems that most learners they learn the communicative strategies and they use in the different tasks. However, men score higher in topic avoidance and circumlocution. I have observed that usually female students start talking and use a lot of non-verbal strategies, and they are a little more, and they have more facility for hesitating and verbal strategies, mainly because of their nature. They, you know, women like to talk a lot. That's why, for example, they use a lot of, in the way of the strategy of circumlocution, they use a lot and they got higher grades. But on the other hand, for example, male learners they score higher in the achievement strategies and reduction strategies. Reduction strategies, we have to remember, it's concerned with topic avoidance. So some learners, some boys, if they didn't like the topic, they didn't continue talking about this. For example, in one of the debates, when they talk about abortion, women talk a lot about abortion, defended men, they were very, they just were straight to the point, and they didn't give too many details. So in this way, I have to say that learners' usage deal more with the type of task, the theme, the level of the learner. So it seems like the use of communicative strategies deal more with the type of the task, how it is used, the prior knowledge that the learner have, also the level of the learner. It doesn't matter if it is a boy or if it is a girl. Both of them are very open to learn, and they can just produce and use the communicative strategies, no matter gender or sex. And finally, I want just to mention very briefly about some of the conclusions. Learners, here after teaching this, we have to conclude that it's very important the explicit teaching of the 10 communicative language, 10 communicative language strategies. In this case, learners are empowered, equipped to use more, and the attitude of the learner change radically when they receive some help. They have tools to use in different situations, and they are very open to talk, not only inside the classroom, but also outside. They look for forums. They start investigating by themselves. Besides of this, I have to tell you that they score better on the oral test. And as I mentioned before, and learners, female and male proficiency learners show a better attitude to communicate and participate in class, as well as they are more communicative, strategic, selective when speaking. Okay, in conclusion, I want to say that it's worth investigating about the speaking ability, and mainly about communicative strategies, because as you know, and today English is a global language. So I think it's too much important for learners to learn how to use the language, because in this way they are going to remember not only the teacher, but learning is going to be memorable when they can see that they can speak, they can communicate, so they are going to enjoy their learning, and they are not going to feel frustrated, they are not going to feel ashamed. And we as teachers, for example, we need also to be aware whenever we plan our classes that it's very important to look for the specific task, but at the same time we have to complement with the specific communicative strategies, because most of the time there are different tasks, different topics, but we just put the students in groups and talk, but some of them they feel really anxious, they really don't know how to start talking. So we need, especially for low proficiency students, it's really crucial to teach communicative strategies. Moreover, teachers, for example, who just finished university, they don't have experience, and in most of the seminars, the majority of the issues are related to listening strategies, of teaching reading, but there is little content and very little information about how to teach, how to help students in communicative situations. That's why the aim of this investigation was both to help teachers to know when to use it, how to use these strategies, and this investigation, I think, is going to be just a kind of basis, and so they can start investigating more and complementing this investigation. Okay, thanks a lot. I really appreciate your time. And also, I feel very happy because I want to say that it was hard for me to investigate, to work, even to do this presentation. It's very challenging to study and to work, it's very demanding. To do an investigation through a panel online, so I was the whole afternoon trying to videotape this presentation. I adjust different things. I buy new headphones, but I don't know. Something happens that it seems like the volume tools is not working well. That's why I'm I am just using another tool. I am just using my camera to videotape this presentation because I know that today is the deadline of this dissertation. So please, thanks again, and I really appreciate your consideration and your understanding, please. I hope you consider my effort, and thanks again to the institution and to Dr. Majid Safran. Thanks a lot. Goodbye.